Good morning all. Myself Srijitas, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, SNS College of Technology. So today we are going to discuss a case study on heat transfer evaluation on microwave sterilization in oil palm fruits. So microwave sterilization is the case study over here. We all know that sterilization is the process of killing or deactivating fungus, germs or certain living organisms in order to increase the quality of our product or quality of the thing that we are going to use. So here we are going to look on the case study of how microwave energy can be effectively used to sterilize oil palm fruit. So we all know oil palm fruit is an edible vegetable oil that is derived from the mesocarp of the fruit. So it is mainly used to extract oil. So we require a pre-treatment to deactivate all that fatty acids in order to increase the quality of oil palm fruit. So let us see how it will work, what are the challenges that we need to face when we go for microwave sterilization. So let us look in detail about the case study. Students, now let us discuss, before discussing the heat transfer evaluation in oil palm fruit using microwave sterilization, let's see what an oil palm fruit branch is. Okay, so the oil palm fruit, it is also called as Elaceous. It is a species of palm community. It is also called as oil palm. Simply, it is commonly known as African palm oil. It is the principal source of palm oil. So palm oil is an edible oil that is used for cooking purpose. It is a native of West and Southwest Africa, specifically the areas between countries like Angola as well as Gambia. The species namely refers to as Guinness, refers to the name of the area, that is Guinea, that it got the species name from, because it is commonly found in this African region. It is not the modern country which now bears that name. So the species also got naturalized in Madagascar. It is commonly found in Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Indonesia, Central America, then in Cambodia, West Indies, and in many island nations in Indian as well as Pacific Ocean. The closely related American palm oil are distinctly related palm. So it is also a variety of species of African palm oil that can be that is used to produce this palm oil. So we have seen the species and the native of this palm oil community, from where it originates, those details. So this palm oil, this oil is extracted from both the pulp of the fruit, that is palm, as well as edible oil, as well as from the kernel of the oil that is used in mainly in food as well as in soap manufacture. So for every 100 kg of fruit bunches, typically 22 kg of palm oil and 1.6 kg of palm kernel oil can be extracted. The high yield oil of palm has made it common for cooking ingredients in Southeast Asia and in tropical belt of Africa. Its increasing use in the commercial food industry in other part of the world is because of its cheaper price. So the price of this is very low when compared to that of sunflower oil as well as coconut oil. So it has a high level of natural antioxidants. So the proper approach of palm oil development begins in the establishment of cover plants. So that is a variety of hybrid variety of this palm oil that yield much more production, much more yield when compared to that of other variety. So the human use of palm oil can be dated from more than 5,000 years ago. Palm oil is in use more than 5,000 years ago. So it is one of the common yield of income in these countries also, especially Malaysia, Cambodia. These countries mainly rely on the income of these countries rely on the production of the palm oil. So proper handling of this palm oil, palm this oil fruit
needs to be done. Proper sterilization of these fruits has to be done, because these fruits contain many fatty, free fatty acids. So we need to deactivate the enzymes that will increase the free fatty acid content that will enhance the oil production or oil extraction. So there comes the use of microwave sterilization. There comes the use of sterilization. So the invention of microwave energy technology, the heat transfer technology, has revolutionized the oil palm fruit bunches, as well as certain challenges was also there in this area. So let us discuss in detail about how microwave sterilization can be used for this. So how it will result in increasing the quality of the oil fruit, etc. So the microwave energy will penetrate into the core of the oil palm fruit bunches and generate the heat inside. This sterilization is aimed to inactivate the lipase. So as I said, this microwave sterilization is that inactivate lipase that influence the palm oil quality. So the case study is mainly that focused on the effect of dielectric properties, power developed per unit volume and interior temperature distribution on a heating rate during the microwave heating process. The experiment carried out of various combinations of microwave power and oil palm bunches portions and the study that is being carried out finds that the interior temperature in a single palm oil fruit was influenced by the power density and fruit's diameter. So these two parameters influence the amount of heat that can be absorbed by the palm oil fruit, that is power density and fruit's diameter. Greater the power density provides high microwave energy per kg sample to attain the greater temperature of microwave heating, and vice versa. The distribution of the interior temperature in the fruit with the thickness of about 6 millimeter and above indicated the non-uniformity in the heating process. So the if the thickness is too high, then it will result in non-uniformity of a heating inside the palm oil fruit. Furthermore, the interior temperature of the fruitlet and the interior temperature distribution will all depends upon the inner wall, that exocarp, the outer wall of that fruit. Exocarp of the fruit will that will have a significant impact on the amount of heat, microwave heat that can be absorbed by that fruit. So every palm oil branches during harvesting and transportation to palm oil milling facilities facilitate the release of free fatty acid by lipase with the presence of water. The sterilization is compulsory in the mill to protect the palm oil quality through inactivation of 90% of this lipase activity at certain time and temperature. So we have seen all these process that happens during this microwave heating. All these process took place results in all these many process, but the first and the initial process that has to be carried out is the sterilization process. Sterilization process will overcome that that water content. It will reduce that moisture content or water content that will result in if it is not sterilized, means it will result in other organisms like fungus affecting the palm oil fruit, and thus affecting the palm oil quality. Even if the single fruit is affected, because it has a bunch, it is being crushed in an oil mill. Even if the single fruit is affected, that will have significant impact on the quality of the oil, palm oil that is being distributed, that is being produced. Okay. So heating temperature process has to be above 50 degrees Celsius. One method of heating of our palm oil is the microwave radiation. The method has several advantages because it can either be carried out very fast at high temperature or proceeded slower at low temperature. So based on our requirement, we can adjust the heating process, whether it can be carried out too fastly or it can be carried out in a step-by-step process. The utilization of the microwave energy to enhance the chemical process such as sterilization, extraction, demetallization reported by several it forms a typical part of the industry right now. So the opportunity to use microwave energy for heating palm oil firstly was introduced in 1980s by Tan, who investigated the dielectric properties and moisture loss of the fresh fruit palm oil during the heating process. So ever since 1980s, many studies reported utilization of the microwave energy for palm oil fruit sterilization with respect to stripping efficiency after sterilization, crucial time and temperature for sterilization, and the quality of the extracted oil. Overall, studies on heating palm oil fruit with microwave energy can be classified into three parts. First one, the study of opportunities for the use of microwave energy to heat the palm oil. The study of quality of the palm oil being heating with the microwave energy, and the study of the ability of the microwave heating facility to release palm oil fruit from the palm oil fruit. So this from the traditional heating method, it has become an innovation there. It has become an new technology or new thing over there. So all the previous studies reported potency of the microwave irradiation to sterilize palm oil fruit at laboratory scale. The microwave irradiation offered various modification of the mode of operation to obtain palm oil with high calorification content, or on the contradictory produce palm oil without any calorification content. The conventional palm oil milling products, crude palm oil that are refined further to remove much as the inner acetic acids content in the palm oil to satisfy the customer. So we can use microwave heating to produce palm oil based on the requirement of the customers, In fact, these edible contents that is present in the microwave fruit is very important to human health because it contains beta acids that act as pro-vitamin A in human living. The fact beta acts destroyed during the sterilization heating process due to high temperature or long period of exposure indicates the sterilization time and temperatures are very crucial in palm oil sterilization by microwave irradiation. Both indicates the significant heat transfer process that occurs during the sterilization of microwave energy. So all the studies reveals the mechanism and the effect of microwave energy transformation into thermal energy at microscopic level. The heat generation occurs prior of the heat transfer and electromagnetic wave applied into the palm oil fruit samples. The interaction between the microwave, the polar water molecules, and charged ions in the oil palm fruit causes water molecules in the oil palm fruit to constantly rotate and couple with the electromagnetic field. The molecular friction resulting from the dipolar rotation of the water molecules generate heat and resulting rise in the fruit temperature in kernel or the outer layer of the fruit, that is the endocup. Furthermore, the heat transfer occurs when the heat flows from the kernel or endocup into the exocup of the oil palm fruit. The heat generation in the concept of microwave heating is indicated by an increase in the temperature of the material per unit of the time, and the heat transfer from the interior of the material into the exterior or surface happens. This is indicated by the difference in the temperature of the interior and the exterior wall of the fruit of the palm oil or the material. At the time the microwave energy is absorbed by the dielectric material, the rate of temperature increases depending upon the number of distinct parameters such as frequency, dielectric loss factor, and electric field. Okay, the rate of heating of the material can be also be expressed with the help of a power equation. So we have to carry out certain steps very carefully. The microwave heating industry has to be very carefully looking into the heat. So this is a typical animated video of microwave heating, microwave sterilization unit for oil palm heating, oil fruit palm heating. So this microwave energy shows significant potency for sterilization of the palm fruit with respect to the dielectric properties. The interior temperature in a single palm fruit was distributed inside out and is less influenced by the power density by the fruit meter. Hence, it is it is identified to be one of the best way to heat the palm oil, and many industries has adopted that. So they have replaced all the conventional heating equipments, and they have been using microwave energy to heat a palm oil, because we can adjust the amount of heat, we can process the palm fruit in such a way according to the requirement of the customer. The greater power density provides high microwave energy per kg sample to attain greater temperature of microwave heating and vice versa. The distributed of interior temperature in the fruit with the thickness of about 6 mm and above indicated non-uniformity heating. That was the problem with this. When we analyze the case study, this is the major setback. Furthermore, the interior temperature of the fruitlet with a radius of 4.5 millimeter indicated distribution of the temperature from the endocarp to exocarp. Meanwhile, the simulation temperature on smaller fruit diameter indicated thermal runaway effect after 5 minutes heating duration. These two are the main drawbacks that we have identified in this case study. So in general, apart from these two drawbacks, microwave heating has